When I decided to start my YouTube channel and structure it around a quarterly theme, I was like, what topic should I start with? And then I was like, well, what's the most frequent developmental edit suggestion that you give? And then the light bulb went off. Setups. Guys, we have to talk about setups. So today's video will be just about briefly defining what setup is and demystifying some of the language around it so you can learn how to revise your setup in a way that enables you to hook a reader and sell them on the premise of your book. The setup refers to the portion of a book that establishes the premise of your story by introducing your main characters and their goals and conflicts, all in a way that makes the reader want to continue reading, and it also addresses genre expectations. Structurally speaking, it's roughly the first 25% of your book. It's the opening line, opening paragraph, opening chapters, maybe 1 to 5, depending on what genre, that lay the groundwork for the rest of the story to make sense and take off in that inciting incident. It includes things like the story hook, your protagonist's main character moments, plus the sequel, which is the emotional fallout that primes the character and the reader who's kind of along for the ride to the dynamics that make the change resulting from the inciting incident possible. From a story perspective, the setup should give character, momentum, setting, while making the reader curious about seeing how these characters will achieve their goals and/or grow over the course of the book. Now that we've kind of established what setup is, let's just talk about the goals and the terms around setup and what elements have to go into it. The goal of your setup is to introduce your characters and garner reader buy-in for your story by creating gripping and intriguing stakes and conflicts that the rest of the story should resolve. In order to do this, you have to include things like the character's age, their name, physical appearance, personality, and traits, and show their character in a way that the reader can relate to them and therefore start caring about them before anything happens. That's how you build reader investment. But at the same time, you can't just show your character sitting there at their breakfast table, talking in their head to the reader like they have all the time in the world. I mean, you can, but it's special. There needs to be a sense of action or momentum to that opening that makes the character's normal life seem very active. I think this is where a lot of authors get a little confused with the whole start with the action thing. We're not talking about fight scenes. When I'm talking about starting close to the action, I'm talking about adding a sense of momentum to your character's normal world such that it doesn't feel like you're spending a lot of time on mundane elements or kind of blowing past the information the reader needs to understand before that inciting incident will make sense or the choices leading up to it. What we're really trying to get you to do is to display the essence of who the character is, of who they are, and how they will respond to conflict or the current conflicts that they're experiencing in a way that feels like the story is moving along. Of course, if your story has an elaborate setting, this is a great time to give the reader a slice of that sense of where this book is taking place or where this particular conflict that they're walking into is taking place and during which time. This sets the boundaries and conditions within the character must operate in, and it shows the reader the character's limitations because of that environment. And of course, at the end of this very elaborate character moment, the reader has to leave with a character arc question, which is basically their understandings of the character's GMCs for the internal conflict. That means basically your story hook. This sketches the form of the POV character's character arcs and shapes the reader's expectations of what implicit or explicit questions will be answered or resolved over the course of the book. The story hook can be related to the plot or story goal. In fact, oftentimes solving those internal character arcs will help them achieve the plot goal or achieve what their plot goals were actually setting out to change. As we get deeper into the quarter and exploring setup, I'll have authors come in and share their process and experience in writing and revising the setups of their books. Make sure you're following me on Instagram because I have a huge announcement on the 9th related to this. So, because you have to juggle all of the elements I mentioned earlier and make sure you're hitting the right notes, writing beginnings is probably the most difficult part of writing a book. I mean, revisions and receiving criticisms is difficult, but when it comes to what's really hard to write, beginnings are like number one on the list of things that makes authors groan. Do I have to revise that again? But wait, it's really important that you get it right, because that's what moves readers or industry professionals out of that immediate DNF action to a story they can't seem to connect to or can't seem to care about. Think about it. A potential reader picks up your book off the shelves at an airport bookstore. I say that because that's where I find some of my favorite authors. Unless they're a little bit different, they're gonna open your book to the first page, maybe read the first page, first chapter, and then if they really have time or a really long layover, the first few chapters. You have that long to sell them on the concept of your book and get them fully invested in the characters so they have no choice but to buy that book before their flight comes. That same exact thing happens when you're pitching your story or your book to an editor or an agent. You don't know how big their slush pile is, so you have a limited window in which you have to convince the editor or agent that your book is worth reading past those first 3,000 to 9,000 words. So revising your setup is totally worth your time, even if you don't get it 100% perfect, because it's still your first introduction to your reader or your agent. I actually don't know how many authors actually publish with their original opening chapters or setup. This quarter, I'll be talking about how you go about doing that. From looking at what you do when your setup doesn't hook your reader, or you might suspect that's the problem, to identifying the character moment you want to start the book with, and how to revise or study other authors or TV show openers to inform your writing and revision process. If you want to learn more about setup, make sure you sign up for my newsletter so that you get my mindset guide on revising the setup, which covers what I've talked about in this video a little bit more in depth. And make sure you subscribe and follow me on my blog and this channel as we dive deeper into all things setup. It sounds like a lot, but don't worry, I got you. And most importantly, you got this. If you have some burning questions about setups or revising the opening chapters of your book, like maybe some feedback or advice you've gotten that you're struggling with from editors, agents, or critique partners, make sure you drop a comment down below, and I can do a my editor said kind of book video answering the most common questions. And if y'all have a lot of questions, I can maybe do a Q&A situation. I will see you next Thursday.